Right now, we usually go to a commercial break, but I'd rather talk about something we love before we cut to commercial because we did not yesterday have the chance to talk about Watchmen.
Yes.
And we are all watching Watchmen. We're all loving Watchmen. And episode 8 aired. And we have passed the 24 hours that I feel like it's respectful enough to talk about in a spoiler way. So let's do a spoiler Watchmen episode 8 conversation. Darina.
Spoilers.
Thank you, Cody.
Spoiler of the century. Is that your blue dong that you're swinging there? Wow, good for you, Cody and D. Good for you.
Definitely some dong in that.
Watchmen, guys, talk to me. Darina, I know that you said that this was your favorite episode
Favorite episode of the season. I think that was a beautiful hour of television. I did not know how they were going to handle the big blue guy, who is obviously one of my favorite characters in the whole comic book. But I loved it. I think it was a beautiful way of doing a love story on TV, a very unique way of storytelling. I also was worried about how it was going to look. And obviously it looks a little bit similar to the Zack Snyder movie, right? Mm. Which is fine because that one looks great.
You mean how Dr. Manhattan was going to look in that form?
Yeah, yeah, just in general, right? I love seeing John talk to Adrian. Like that scene, I was like, oh, my nerd feels were like, holy crap. Like that was awesome. I was very happy with it.
Same. This was, it's hard to say. Last episode might still be my favorite, but this is now up there. Because I, like you, love Dr. Manhattan. I wanted to know how are they going to pull it off.
Mm-hmm.
Not only that, just I wanted to see Dr. Manhattan fuck shit up.
Yeah.
And he fucked shit up. Mm. I was so excited. I'm sorry about it. I'm a big nerd about
this.
Don't
be sorry for being
it
excited.
It was getting to that point of like, how are they going to pull off Dr. Manhattan? And I thought it was so brilliantly done. The mystery of where he is, learning who he is, and then seeing his power come out. That was something that I really wanted to see, the nerd in me, but just how they handled it. It was so beautiful. And the performance, just everything. I'm still going crazy. I walked into my house last night and went, I want to watch Watchmen again. I really want to see that episode again because there is so much going on underneath just like the themes and the idea that he's choosing a body and why he chooses this body. And then
so glad they explained that.
Yeah.
There was a lot of talk on the internet about what it meant that a blue man chose a black man, and what I like the fact that Regina King just thought that he was hottest.
Right.
Yeah.
Like no, that he's sexy.
It could be as simple as that.
Yeah.
It could be something deeper. And that's what this series is doing is the various layers that we have that they deal with in this like kind of alternate future or alternate reality. But I just adored this episode.
John, you share a first name with the blue guy. What's up?
I do. Here's the deal with
no
this.
H.
Yeah, I wish. I would love to be Dr. Manhattan, Jesus. Which, what is amazing is...
No, you'd be sad.
He's sad.
I don't know, maybe. The idea of...
You don't think Dr. Manhattan's
the
sad?
Relationships... Well, I don't know if he conceives of
your whisper
human
voice,
emotion.
Man.
But no, because then you're never... Really quick, sorry. But you're never surprised, though, if you're him, right? Like, you know everything that's happening.
Right.
That's what's so heartbreaking about the character.
Right, that's a fair point. Yeah. And that's what she calls him out on,
yeah,
right? When's
exactly.
the last time you were fucking... afraid of anything.
Exactly.
50 fucking years or whatever she says. But what I thought was brilliant too is whenever we're in a relationship, isn't it always all the timelines happening with us? All the timelines. You're always remembering the first time. You're always remembering
totally.
The best times, the worst times. So to me, although Riley's right, it was a unique way to see it presented on the screen. It's legitimately how we actually perceive our relationships.
And our memories. Yeah.
I mean, Roxy, we were just talking about the journey. We immediately flashed like 4 or 5 different memories. That's how we live in our world.
Yeah.
So why wouldn't
that's
you?
That's great, dude.
I love what you just said because I think that's why it did touch home for so many people. Whether it's love, friendship, whatever it is, even me and you talking about our relationship, I'm sure as we're talking about it, it's like I can think of 5 distinct things like about the journey, or if you think about your current significant others, your exes, like all throughout the why you hold things against them, there's some things that just never go away,
some
things that you remember stronger than others. So I think that is why we did connect to it. But I will say I love this episode. I love this show. And this is an emotion I think that they want me to feel, but I do feel incredibly frustrated watching this sometimes.
Really?
Yeah, because, and I think I'm supposed to, but first of all, I'm screaming at the motherfucking television.
Mm-hmm.
Move. 1 inch to your left, 2 inches to your right, go up in the air, duck down, fucking move, bitch. Like, move.
Get out the way.
Right? Boom, 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 boom. I'm killing everybody. And now you know that that is behind you. Move.
Right, right.
But he can't. But why can't you? The power of free will in general is something that is so important to me. And watching somebody who seemingly does not have that because they know everything that's happened is like pulling my eyelashes out one by one. Right. I just want to scream for them.
Think about it this way. Doctor Strange in Endgame.
No, I hate Doctor Strange.
Yeah, I know. But no, the inevitability.
This is a better version of Doctor Strange.
Yes, the inevitability of this needs to happen.
No,
I need
different.
To get, and no, so we're gonna.
Riley,
you don't think
it's
so?
It's different because what he says is there are 1,000,005 possibilities.
Right.
What Dr. Manhattan says is this is what's happening.
This is the only
this
timeline.
Is the only timeline.
So let me clarify. So he knows that it's inevitable that he has to be taken out by this gun, whatever it is, for her to maybe survive.
It's not that he knows it's inevitable that it has to happen somehow. He knows it's happening this how.
Right.
This
right.
way.
And so he has to follow that through.
But that's so different than this might happen and there's one chance that it doesn't. He's saying this is what's up and she keeps fighting that, which is what I would do if I was Regina King. You fight that, right?
That's
like
what I
loved. If somebody tells you this is what's happening, the kind of person I am, I'm like, no fucking way.
But,
and when she goes outside and he says, this is the moment I fell in love with you, she says, you just fell in love with me 10 years later. No, I've always been in love with you. Like the whole thing, I just want to punch somebody. In a good way.
And I think this is correct because this is the microcosm of what he represents.
Right.
Which is religion. He represents a God.
Totally.
He is a God. You are frustrated by it. Why do children die? God, why do children die?
Right. Yeah.
Why does this happen?
Why is there
why
war?
Why does the Blade
Runner.
Right, exactly. Why does the lead singer of Roxette get a brain tumor when she's brought so much joy to so many people with her music? That's the world, right? And you're frustrated because you're like, why is this happening the way it's happening? So if God was actually on earth, he'd be like, this is what's going to happen. And you'd watch it happen. You're like, why? And that's what, I mean, as soon as he created those creatures and created the world, you're just like, he's God. So we're watching him. And he's when he walked on water, it was like the banging on the head type of situation. And so this is why he did it the way he did it. And he was so calm about it. Like Shannon last night was like, why wasn't he more dynamic? Like doing no-look kills. I'm like, that's not what Dr. Manhattan or God
He's
would do.
He's never been that.
That's right. It's not necessary.
It's
inevitability.
The inevitability of it. He knows
inevitable.
That it's no matter what it's going to happen. But I think there's something that he knows that we don't yet.
Let me ask you guys this then. If there's things that he knows that we don't, which I'm sure there are a bajillion of them, but the one that I'm curious about is what he ends up doing with Adrian because he sends him somewhere. He says, do you want to go? Obviously knowing what his answer is going to be and sends him. And then the whole post-credit thing with the horseshoe and the cake. What is happening here? And is Dr. Manhattan setting Adrian up for success or failure?
That's a good question. Or redemption.
That's what I think.
Yeah.
Redemption would be success.
Success.
Right.
Right.
On Earth.
I'm just putting it a different way because of the character we know, what happened in the Watchmen comic, how he now ends up on Europa.
Yeah.
But what would that redemption be then? What does that look like?
See, that's where it's like...
Is that part of God's plan or the universe's plan, right? Like, that's the thing. It's like, we don't know. It's the same as like how like Rorschach ends up.
Right.
Does that make... Like, why did he do that, right? Why did Dr. Manhattan do that? Like, we don't know, right? Like, that's the thing. He knows why these things happen and what his duty is in this timeline or whatever, right? Because he represents time.
Let me ask you guys this one. Do you hate him?
No.
Dr. Manhattan?
Yeah.
No.
Do you?
God, no.
Yes, I hate him.
Really?
Yeah, I hate him.
Okay,
I hate
why?
Him.
Why?
Fascinating.
I hate him.
That's
Do people have reasons?
Usually,
but
it's okay.
If you don't know,
that's one conversation.
It's not that I don't know. It's that I hate him for who he is.
Okay.
I hate what he says. I hate how he acts. Mm-hmm. I hate him.
Calculating.
I think it's not
without
that
emotion.
Does he annoy you?
No, because he totally has. I think that he has way more emotion than I figured he would have.
See, I didn't see emotion when he was sitting in the bar. It was more when he became...
Oh, there was emotion in that bar. There was tons of it.
When he tells her he loves
him. Does he annoy you as a character in the book? Or just what he's representing right now?
He doesn't annoy me.
Okay.
It's
the point of the show right now.
But why though? Like the character itself?
Maybe for the reason that I'm not religious.
Okay.
I don't believe in that. I think that it's wrong.
Fair.
I believe in freedom of choice and will and power.
Okay.
And and people not being all-knowing, even if he is, I think that that's a crappy quality to have. If somebody knows everything, what do they have to learn? What do they have to gain? What do they have to do with people?
But he's not human, though.
I don't appreciate that he still ends up being with Regina. I think that it's a selfish choice because he loves her and he doesn't have to do to her what he does to her. I hate him. I love his character. He's an excellent character, but no, I hate him.
This has always been Manhattan's thing, though, which is why I push back when people say he's not human. He is human.
He's human.
He's still at the base human, which is why he pursues love.
It's kind of like Spock, right? Where like
where
he has a little bit of human in him, but then he's doing what he thinks is logical.
Right, but Spock's never had the Spock's weakness or whatever you want is Achilles' heel has always been his emotion. Dr. Manhattan's is always love.
Right.
Yeah.
And the first woman he was with then cheated on her, gave her cancer, but cheated on her with a younger woman and then she's still in love with him and she calls him and leaves the jokes. She's still somewhat in love with him.
Lori
still, and here he is doing this with Regina because he's fallen in love with her. So he's always, no matter how powerful he is, he is always still subject to the human emotion of love and destroys things around him in pursuit of that, a human does sometimes.
And I don't care. I know that people are saying he's not making choices, but I believe it is a choice. Mm. I believe going into that bar is a choice. I believe introducing
himself. I think that's absolutely fair.
I agree. I completely agree with that.
A choice for a bigger outcome. If he doesn't make that choice to go tell her that he loves her, knowing what he knows for the future, I think it's all connected somehow, we just don't know how yet.
I'm not
but
even
he
saying,
still has a choice, like Roxy's
saying. I'm not saying he's the worst person on the planet. I'm not saying anything other than I hate him. Like, I think he is, of all of them, I hate him more than I hate Adrian.
Should we get you a shirt that says, I hate Dr. Manhattan?
But
that is a great shirt, actually.
Cody, how do you feel?
Oh, this is a good conversation you guys are having. Good job, gang.
Hey, thanks, Cody.
I love this episode, and I love that it kind of put to bed the notion that Lindelof doesn't understand Dr. Manhattan. That's what a lot of people were saying at the end of the last episode. Like, he would never come back. Why would he come back to Earth? He gave up on humanity. And I thought this episode showed that Lindelof understands that character perfectly.
Yeah.
That's a great point, Cody. Yeah.
I agree. I'm now curious at the end of this series or season, if it's not going to get a season two, I'm still confused on what's happening there.
The rumors are there is a season two, but Lindelof is not coming back.
Wow. That scares me.
Then I think there should be no season two. But
I think
for me, I'm going back and forth. My favorite Lindelof show is Leftovers.
Yeah.
But I love Lost as well, and I'm wondering, with a couple of years' distance, where Watchmen's going to fall. If it does take that number one spot, if it's two, if it's three, if he does do a second season, if Lindelof comes back, or how that show gets tainted, if he doesn't, a lot of questions about Lindelof in general.
Yeah. It's also funny that I was one of those like Lost finale haters, and now I'm like, and then Prometheus, I'm like, Prometheus was like half really great and half of it didn't like, and now I'm like, I am a Damon Lindelof fan now. I don't know how that happened, but it happened with Watchmen. So there you go.